So one of the first things I do every single time I buy a car is I change the spark plugs out, I change out the valve cover gasket, sometimes the oil pan gasket, and then I start looking at motor mounts and things like that. Just basic stuff that I feel like the last owner probably didn't do and stuff that I want peace of mind about. So I did that with this Audi, and one of the things that I did was change out the spark plugs. Well, with the Audi, I didn't know at the time, but they're really, really sensitive to spark plug gap, and I haven't really had a car that was sensitive to spark plug gap, and so I put in some spark plugs, and I've had kind of a rough running car since, and I'm thinking that it's probably the gap in the spark plug. It's supposed to be 0.032 or something like that, and I think mine are like 0.4 or maybe they're 0.27. I can't remember. I just put them in there though. I didn't even check the gap. So I got a little gapper tool. I'm gonna gap these, and I just figured I'd show you because it's an easy process and it's something you can do at home, and the tool is like a dollar. So I'm gonna pull a spark plug out and show you how I do it. I don't have a solution for this. This is that rubber gasket that goes inside of here, and it keeps coming out. So if you know of a way to keep that in there so that it doesn't get stuck to the spark plugs, let me know. So on this, you have your numbers, and as you go around, it gets bigger or smaller. And so you're gonna set your gauge right here and go until you get to 32. Now right now, I was about right, I'm at 40. And I think that's just too much. See, it's like 30.039, something like that. So I need to go back down. So 0.032 is all the way over here. So I need to go back down to that. Those two, so I've still got a gap, even though I've been bending it. Also, check out the car's Band-Aid. Let's see. So now, let's see if it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it's intervals of 1. So now if I put it on right here, not touching. I'm at 0.034. So I need to make it smaller. Now I'm at 0.032. I'm sure you guys can see that. 0.032. I think that's it. I'm gonna get on Google real quick and make sure before I put this thing back in. Okay, so I just checked Pelican Parts and it says 0.032 for a stock engine, and that is my engine, so 0.032 it is. I'm gonna go do the other four. I got some new coils too, but I'm gonna put these spark plugs in and see if it made a difference changing the gap from 40 to 32 before I do anything else. So that's spark plug gapping. It's a really easy thing to do. That's the way I do it. That's the way I know how to do it. If there's a better way, let me know in the comments. But it's such a small thing, but if you have an Audi, they are very picky about their ignition system, and so make sure that you have the right gap. What I read on the internet was 32 was a good gap for a stock boosted car, and when you go up into higher boosts, 0.28 is better. That's off of Pelican Parts. I really trust that site. I use them for most of my work on German cars. I used them the entire time I owned my E90, and they saved me thousands and thousands of dollars. I also spent thousands of dollars on that car, but that's another point. But it's a great site. Go check it out if you have a German car. It will help you a huge, huge amount. See you soon.